I'll be safe if I can make it there. I hope. Please let me make it there. So surreal.
Famously called film Little Pieces of Time. But he could be talking about photography, as he likely was.
Okay. I'm in class. Everything's cool. I am okay.
From light to shadow. From color to chiaroscuro. Now, can you give me an example of a photographer who perfectly captured the human condition in black and white?
I didn't fall asleep, and that sure didn't feel like a dream.
Bueller.
Weird.
Diane Arbus.
There you go, Victoria. Why Arbus?
Look at this crap. How can I show this to Mr. Jefferson? I can hear the class laughing at me now.
You feel like totally haunted by the eyes of those sad mothers and children.
I can't believe I still have this pencil case. I should upgrade to the 21st century. But I like it old school.
Seriously, though. I could frame any one of you in a dark corner.
I haven't kept up with my journal as much as I should. If anybody else looked at this, what would they think?
And any one of you could do that to me. Isn't that too easy? Too obvious? What if Arbus chose to capture people at the height? Shh. I believe Max has taken what you kids call a selfie. A dumb word for a wonderful photographic tradition. And Max has a gift. Of course, as you all know, the photo portrait has been popular since the early 1800s. Your generation was not the first to use images for selfie expression. Sorry, I couldn't resist. The point remains that the portraiture has always been a vital aspect of art and photography for as long as it's been around. Now, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits?
You're asking me? Let me think.
You either know this or not, Max. Is there anybody here who knows their stuff?
Louis Daguerre was a French painter who created daguerreotypes, a process that gave portraits a sharp reflective style like a mirror. Now you're totally stuck in the retro zone. Sad face.
Very good, Victoria. The Daguerrean process brought out fine detail in people's faces, making them extremely popular from the 1800s.
If any...
Onward. The first American daguerreotype self-portrait was done by Robert Cornelius.
Sorry, Max. No more selfies right now.
In your textbook. Or even online. And guys, don't forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday Heroes contest. I'll fly out with the winner to San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the art world. It's great exposure, and it can kickstart a career in photography. So Stella and Alyssa, get it together. Taylor, don't hide. I'm still waiting for your entry, too. And yes, Max, I see you pretending not to see me. Yes, Victoria.
Victoria doesn't waste a second.